rime interim lanciremo dorime ameno o mandare in terra via me.
She's cold. She's really cold.
Oh, Mary, I was
You know this girl? It's entirely false.
What happened?
No, Joey.
Basically, what happened?
Sorry. From the moment I met you, you have dominated my soul.
Yes.
I worship you with far more romance than a man usually gives to a woman. From the moment I saw you, your beauty had the most extraordinary influence over me. I quite admit that I adored you madly, extravagantly, absurdly. Of course I never let you know anything about this.
About what?
This would have been impossible.
What?
You would have understood it.
Understand what?
I hardly understood it myself.
Tell me now.
I only knew that your perfect face made a world seem wonderful to my eyes.
Yes.
And as I painted your picture, I knew.
What?
I knew that every fleck of pain, every brush of struggle to rebuild my love, it was so wrong and foolish back then. It is still so wrong and foolish now.
Dana, I need your help.
What happened to Lord Mason? I just saw him fine when I went to bed, and now? Excuse my dislike, but what have you done to him?
I need you to get rid of his body.
No, no, I'm sorry, but it's a big issue in which you got involved, and I don't want to be involved too. I beg your pardon, but I'm leaving now, and if you wish something else, please let me know.
No, wait. Hey. Dana, it wasn't like that. Of course not. I can't believe what you're going to need to do. You know me, Dana. I wouldn't be capable of doing something like that. And furthermore, not one of my best friends. It was an accident. We went upstairs because he needed something for his journey. But as he was in a hurry, he fell. His legs and fell down all through the staircase. That's why his face is so disfigured by these wounds. Poor boy. I warned him about the slippery floor, but probably he has forgotten. God, Father in the sky, let his soul rest in peace.
But why is he in this room?
I was frightened of an anybody gets coming this morning and misunderstand the whole situation, just like you did. That's why I moved him here and clean away the blood.
Why would you do that? That makes you even more suspicious.
Don't understand, Dana. A dead body is resting in my house. Can't you imagine the police and the press around my house speculating about the whole situation? And finally, let me tell you, and finally, printing lies. Dana, if the reputation in my house is endangered, I'm sorry, but I could not guarantee a place for you to work. Then I would have to find you, but I don't want to, of course not. Now tell me, are you going to help me? Remember that I could even pay you twice your salary.
Well, Master, it seems like I have no other choice than to help you doing it.
Yes. Thank you so much, Dana. I knew I could really rely on you. I don't want to fire you, of course, now. I don't want to dismiss you out of your service. which has lasted at least for the last 3 generations of my family. What I don't want to is to lose this very attractive woman I consider you.
Dorian, you're such a charmer, I'm a flatterer.
And do you remember? Basil goes out to Paris, and after a couple of months, no one is going to miss me. And after that time, it's going to be really difficult to find him back. And now tell me, how shall you do this?
Oh, I think I know just the perfect way of getting rid of Basil's back.
Good.
By tomorrow, he could be gone with the wind.
Gone with the wind? That's brilliant. Oh, I'm sorry. For tonight, I have to announce an excuse. I have to call Lord Henry. I promised him to meet him at the opera tonight.
Oh, no, Master! Don't do it, please! Let me take care of this here. It is everything in my hands, and you can go to your club and enjoy it. I will not disappoint you.
Oh, Lena, thank you so much. Well, I have to go.
You mean you can't pull me to me?